All right, you're done. Let's take a look at the solution. While we cannot insert a vector directly, we can easily convert a vector to an array. Once we've done this, the bulk insert method will insert very efficiently. As you can see, we've uncommented out these next series of lines. This allows us to test our output to make sure that we've actually inserted the right thing into the database. Let's actually run our app. And as you can see, we're actually reading the data out of the database that we just inserted, all correctly. Now, our backend will update efficiently, but we really need a way to update the frontend without doing it on the main UI thread. Now our backend will update efficiently, but we really need to be querying things before requesting them from the internet. After all, the point is to have a responsive application. We're still not even updating the screen until after we've pulled data down from the web. We also want to avoid doing our query on the UI thread, because doing operations like queries on the UI thread cause Android to not be able to draw frames fast enough, which introduces frame rate jitter. Fortunately, Android offers a pattern for that known as loaders.